adorable.
Let's talk about your great new film. You play Nell Phillips. Nell is an author, writes a book about the small town of Springdale,
yes.
Right? Okay, so tell us the significance that Springdale has to Nell and why it all kind of ties together.
So Springdale is very special to her because her old coworker, Emmett Turner, played by Christopher Palaha, grew up there. And so he's told her a ton of stories of how the town comes together to celebrate Christmas in the huge festive way that they do. So it's her first time visiting, and it ends up being the first time she sees Emmett since he stood her up a few years ago in New York. So.
You're right.
Man, we don't know why.
No, but I bet you he has a good reason.
He does. He really does.
You can't tell us what it is.
No.
Can't tell you what it is.
But there's a good reason. Well, we have a clip of Nell seeing Emmett for the first time in the bookstore and realizing that there still are quite a bit of feelings there.
Yes.
Yeah.
That I will say. Yeah.
Take a look.
Yeah, here it is.
Couldn't have just stuck with the basics, huh? Fiction, nonfiction.
Well, I think that it's a very successful system. It's one of the innovations I implemented when I took this place over. Wow, it's the only innovation. But...
I just hope my book doesn't end up with the one-hit wonders.
Highly unlikely. In fact, I created a section especially for you. Come here. Where is it? A heartfelt Christmas with a strong female hair.
Okay, looks like I should get cracking on that sequel.
And I wanted you to have a proper Springdale welcome with an absurdly large sign.
Wow. Emmett, this story is incredible.
Oh,
wow.
That is really sweet.
It was fun.
I know watching that too, we talked a little bit about this. So this was, you were living out a fantasy of yours because you got to live out that library moment from Beauty and the Beast.
Absolutely, which I feel like is every girl's dream is to like climb up on one of those ladders and then like swing around.
No.
They had one of those.
There she is.
Two of those. Oh, there it is.
Yes.
Gosh. Did they have them locked in or were you able to swing?
Yeah, unfortunately, you know, for everybody's safety or something like that, they had it all locked. So I couldn't spin around as many times as I'd like
well,
to.
Well, when everybody kind of is breaking down, I'm sure you kind of like flipped off.
Yeah.
I tried. Well,
you tried.
Failed, but
okay,
I tried.
Okay, well, yeah. To try. You look good. It was great for a photo, great for social
right.
media.
Yeah.
Okay. You are from Kitchener, Ontario.
Yes.
I am from Sarnia, Ontario, originally. I like to think that we have good
so
folks
crazy.
In our neck of the woods.
Yeah.
And to that fact, your parents really instilled in you at a very young age the value, the importance of helping others. Tell us about the angel tree and the significance behind it.
Yeah, so the angel tree was a massive Christmas tree that had ornaments on it with boy or girl and their age on it. And every year, our very first Christmas present that we bought that year, we had to pick from the angel tree. Mm. And the rule was we would go to the toy store with my mom and we had to pick out a toy that we wanted. And that's what we would give to the angel tree to the less fortunate
wow.
family.
How wonderful is that? That's so wonderful.
It was
they do that here too. It's a really wonderful thing, and I think that's something that everyone should instill
that's
in their
so
children.
Great.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean,
yeah.
Taking that gift that you want and then getting
and
the feeling
back.
Of what it's like to give
right.
it away.
Yeah, it was a good feeling too because you felt that and you're like, I get to make a kid happy like I get happy. And
that's the point.
It really
right.
brings yeah. tears to my eyes. Besides just being so wonderful and your parents instilling those wonderful values in you, you also have some amazing Christmas traditions that I'm going to tell you right now, Ashley. I won't say steal, but I'm borrowing them this year.
Absolutely.
I saw these photos and I said, oh, I'm doing this exact same thing. Tell us about some of these pictures.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Oh, that's a gingerbread.
Our gingerbread
that's
house.
That's pretty legit, I got to tell you.
That's
you guys didn't mess around when it came to gingerbread.
We've got Beauty and the Beast as figurines in those.
Oh, you do?
Too.
No,
yeah.
This is just covered in wrapping paper?
So on Christmas Day, when we're opening presents, all the wrapping paper stays on the ground so that after it's all done, we all kind of roll around in it
this.
And make wrapping paper angels. We're all giant.
You look like
children.
You're really deep
yeah.
in there, too.
I'm doing that this year.
Yeah.
And this is one of my favorites. I love the pajama pictures when everyone does it. But when you have about 73 people in your picture, this makes it really
epic. Oh yeah, that's my dad's side of the family. That's on Christmas Eve. Even my Nana and Papa are in their onesies, and then we did the pyramid with my cousins, and that was hilarious.
I mean, how many pair of pajamas?
Yeah, how many in total? That company was thrilled when they got that phone call.
I know. My mom did that.
No kidding.
Yeah, there was, there must have been, I think, 14 of us. My math might be wrong on that, but somewhere around there.
That's
awesome.
Think
about that. We might have to up that.
Yeah, we're going to have to do that. I think the whole cast and crew here are going to be wearing the same pajamas.
It's comfortable. It's really comfortable.
But you and your family, you don't stop at matching pajamas. You actually make the best Christmas cards every year. This is coming from a guy who really puts a lot of time into his family's Christmas cards. You guys really take it next level.
Thank you.
But the common theme, I think, in these cards is your brother definitely gets singled out quite a bit.
Yes, he does. He's the only boy of three girls, which I think makes him the most amazing human, having grown up with three very strong personality.
I love your sister on the phone. Is that you on your phone? No, down on the bottom.
Down on the bottom is my sister Paige.
Not even interested. They're not interested.
You can't listen. Look at him sitting in Santa's lap.
This is true commitment to the Christmas card right there.
Yep, we're all in our pajamas.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, a Christmas carol. That's
Christmas story.
A Christmas story, yeah. Excuse me. Oh my gosh, so funny.
They're so good. And this one gets you. It's when the boyfriends come home. Home invasion.
Yes.
Here come the boyfriends and the brother is in trouble.
Oh yeah, because last year was the first year that my boyfriend joined us for Christmas, and we hadn't done anything like that before, so it was very new, and it went off great.
It's
Everyone
loved
him.
It's the best. Well, Merry Christmas. Thanks for
being here. Happy holidays.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Be sure to watch Ashley in Small Town Christmas this Sunday, December 16th at 9/8 Central on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries.